week of entertainment here in Ennis, Texas at the Texas Motorplex that began with a massive country music concert and has rolled through a rodeo and so many other different aspects of the stampede of speed culminates today. It is race day here at the Texas Fall Nationals for the 39th time in Ennis, Texas at this racetrack that opened in the mid-80s and ushered in a new era of competition with its all-concrete surface here in the great state of Texas. They're rolling. It was Ashley out first and at the finish line. It's Ashley. 377.5 beats a 377.6. That was a season hinging moment, and they have taken away Antron Brown out of competition. Either. He smokes the tires. Terry Haddock has problems in Austin Proc by the skin of his teeth. A 438. Beats a 440, a 275. That wasn't just desperation. That was a guy just saving his own race day. She's making him wait. Yeah, she's hanging him out to drive from pre-stage on. And Matt Hartford's out early. He had a slight advantage off the starting line. Is there enough race car to stop Erica Enders? And it is on a hole shot. You got to be kidding me. 661.6 at 208 miles an hour. Enders runs 661.3 at 208. And my goodness, what a turn of events here. Both cars launch off the starting line. Glenn is 15 green and Stanfield's car is not running. And Dallas Glenn, a dream come true for this guy. A second round victory over the man closest to you in the points. This is the time to make hay while the sun shines.
Tough way to end the day for Funny Car Points leader Austin Proc. Austin, when you tried doing the burnout and things went sideways, let's say, what was going through your mind?
Just trying to diagnose the issue. You know, my foot went all the way to the floor, so there was two things. You either broke the throttle cable or the throttle linkage disconnected. It's on a quick disconnect that's, you know, activated by air. And I stopped and noticed that the throttle arm was moving and there was no, you know, change in RPM. So I got on the radio, told them what was going on, and we tried reconnecting it, but we weren't able to due to, you know, pretty much just an error on assembling the race car. So tough break, not the way we wanted to, you know, leave here, but, you know, it was still a good weekend. We went to the semis again and try and get them in Vegas and, you know, see if we can't sew this thing up.
Any solace in seeing Caps go out there and go a 390?
No, that was a great run, you know, but I think we could have hung with him. You know, our package is right with his, so I'm sure it would have been a hell of a drag race.
Gianna Evaristo trying to take out Gaige Herrera. 00 last round. Herrera is very late last round. He can't afford it, and she needs to do it again. both machines heading down the racetrack. It is Gianna Evaristo has some sort of a distraction on the starting line as Herrera, a massive, massive advantage to leave 683.5 at 199 for the win. Smith hunkered down behind the windscreen. Good drag race here, and Smith has enough motorcycle. 687 at 200 miles an hour. Takes out the 690 at 197. He still needs to find 400s for Gaige in the final. Matt revving the engine. Attempting to throw Gaige Herrera off his cadence. Matt got a little bit of a lead off the starting line, but that is not going to be near enough. He has shut his motorcycle off, and Gaige Herrera has continually, as he has done once again, shut off the hopes of anybody else of winning around here. 681-6 at 200.
Gaige, in managing the threat of Matt Smith today, you have become the quickest person in NHRA history to achieve 20 career wins. Brian Lone said that you are living a dream. How big is it?
It's the biggest dream you could ever live. You know, as being a little kid, just dreaming of racing NHRA, you know, now I'm here living it and doing it. And it's hard to believe, you know, it's crazy. You know, it's awesome racing Matt Smith and all the competitors in NHRA Pro Side Motorcycle. And for me to accomplish so much of that, I have in such a short time, I got to give it all up to Vance Hines, Andrew, Motul, Revzilla, Suzuki, Terry Vance, Byron Hines. I mean, this one's for them. This means a lot, especially going in this countdown. The points and everything are pretty tight, and we just got a little more cushion, and we're going to try to keep it going. Woo! But we love it.
Yeah. Greg Anderson leaves on Jeg. Did all those mechanical changes help to turn the tide? It is going to be Jeg Coughlin. 59 with a 3, beats a 60 with a 3. The team celebrating for themselves and for Mark Ingersoll, who's watching from home. What an incredible final round. 10 inches margin of victory.
In the battle of the greats, it goes to Jeg Coughlin Jr. this time. And by the time Pomona comes around, can you be relevant in this countdown?
I can be relevant and maybe helping some others out. But, you know, we kind of shot ourselves in the foot with those couple 1,000 losses early in the countdown. But heck with all that. How about this big win in Ennis, Texas? Billy Meyer and the entire family, thank you for what an event. It's been a hot event. Thanks to all the fans for coming out. Mark Ingersoll, we love you, buddy. We miss you. And, you know, this one's definitely for him. This one's going to Chicago with the next train that goes there. And we know he's going to get well and be back with us next season. So, and all of our partners, Skag, Outlaw Beer, Jegs, thank you for all the love and support. And I can tell you, we're going to celebrate this one in good Texas style.
Cap seeking his first win since the U.S. Nationals of 2023. Hagan made the first move as they get down to the top end of the racetrack. Matt Hagan has done it on a hole shot. 394 beats a 393. You talk about a team who has been just gnawing at it, trying to get a win. They last won in Chicago. They last made a final in Charlotte, and they have won here.
You can just imagine the celebration of Matt Hagan. And Matt, you called it an old school matchup between you and Ron Capps. And to come out on top of a matchup with someone you've been competing with for so long on a hole shot. How validating is that?
You can't call it a whole shot. I mean, we're in the finals and there's nothing to lose. So it definitely wasn't a whole shot win. But to race Ron is badass. I love that guy. He's been my mentor for so long. Just our guys, man. We had a lot of stuff going on internally with our guys, and they worked so hard, figured it out, and we won this race. Jason Johnson with Johnson Horsepower Garage. Woo, this one's yours, baby. We've been working a long time to get here, and we're going to party tonight. That's for sure. Maybe we just burn this whole place down. You know what I mean? Woo!
Both cars roaring into the Texas afternoon, and at the finish line stripe, it's a hole shot win for Ashley. He has done it again in an 0-26 light. How do you stop it? How do you stop it? 77 beats a 76.
And Bruno, before he got out of his dragster, he looked to the sky and climbed out, taking in the moment. And Justin, Brian Lone said after that run, what stops that? A 26 reaction time and a hole shot win. How do you make it look so easy?
Divine intervention. this weekend speaks to God's presence in our lives. I'm a little bit emotional about this one. We had unique circumstances, but our team came through. And to be able to get a win for Team Toyota, but to be able to double up was Jeggy. For everybody at Skag Power Equipment, Metalcraft of Mayville, Skag Australia, Skag Southwest, this is a really special victory. This victory is because of Randy Maria and the team at Skag, and the team that we have working on this race car could not be more proud and thankful. Thank you.